Hey, Pastor Bill here. Today's scripture is from Philippians chapter 3, verse number 1, just the first bit at least. Here Paul writes this, "My brothers and sisters, rejoice in the Lord." Now, up to this point, Paul has written about having joy as it relates to all sorts of things, okay? He's talked about having joy due to his relationship and his partnership with the church in Philippi. He's written about having joy as it relates to the good news of Jesus Christ spreading throughout the Roman Empire. He's written about having joy because he has this confidence. He knows that one day, soon, he's going to be delivered or released from prison. And he also has joy as it relates to the unity within the church. Now, in life, there's all sorts of things that we can be happy about. Family, friendships, right? Finances, food. Don't even get me started on food. I'm actually really, really hungry right now. But even the fact that we're alive is something worthy to be happy about. Yet, Paul tells us this, not simply to be happy or glad about things, rather to rejoice in the Lord. Now, right now, no matter where you're at, no matter what's going on in your life, choose to do this. Be happy about God. Choose to think about Him. Think about how much He loves you. He sent His one and only Son to die on a tree for your sins and for my sins. He loves us so much that after 3 days, He raised Jesus from the dead for our justification. Meaning this, sinners like me and you, we can stand before God on that day innocent. And simply by believing and trusting in the finished work of Christ, we are adopted by faith into God's family. Check it out, forever, no strings attached. Let's meditate on His truth. Let's remind ourselves how good God is and how good He's been to us. And let's say, maybe even shout, thank you. Let's experience God today by rejoicing in the Lord.